साइमोसिन्फ्लोरसेंस। साइमोसिन्फ्लोरसेंस आर दोस वेयर द एपिकल बड टर्मिनेट इन ए फ्लावर। इन द केस ऑफ रसिमोस एपिकल बड इज ए ग्रोइंग टिप, इट कंटिन्यूस ग्रोथ, बट इन साइमोसिन्फ्लोरसेंस एपिकल बड टर्मिनेट्स इन ए फ्लावर। So if a single flower is seen like that, it is called a solitary cymose inflorescence, and if it has multiple branches, they can be two branches dication, then it can be, if there are more branches, that is called a polycation. If there is only one bunch, it is called a monocation, and it can be again divided into scorpioid and helicoid. These are the different types of cymose inflorescence. Let's see one by one. See, this is the cymose inflorescence. Let's see how they are. See the diagram on the upper side. These are called a solitary cyme. What does it mean? On the right side diagram, see, this is a flower. This is a plant. Plant is producing only a single flower, and it is having a bract. And when a flower is having this kind of single pedicellate flower with bract, that is called a solitary cyme. And also, this is a growing branch. This is a branch and inflorescence. This is a growing branch. On this branch, from each axil, only one flower is formed. From each axil, one axil, one flower matrame varunnullu. Idu endanu solitary cyme. This is also solitary cyme. So the case is whether it is a terminal single flower or it is an axial single flower, that is solitary, provided it should have a pedicel and a bract. See the right side diagram. See the diagram on the right side. This is a inflorescence. The terminal flower ended in a flower. The lateral bud developed to form two branches. There also terminal bud ended in a flower. From the lateral buds, two smaller flowers developed. So this is one inflorescence giving two branches, and each branchlets are a cymose inflorescence. So two simple cyme, simple cyme. This is a simple cyme. Each branchlet is a simple cyme. So this kind of, when a inflorescence gives rise to two branches, simple cymes, that is called a dicotyl cyme. See the diagram on the left side. If you see this diagram, the terminal flower ended in a flower. The terminal bud ended in a flower. It produced multiple simple cymes. See, this is a simple cyme with terminal flower, with terminal bud with a flower. This is second one, third one, fourth one. So this is the case where the cymose inflorescence is having multiple simple cymes from the lateral buds. This is called a polycational cyme. So when it produced two simple cymes, it's dication. When it produced more than two, it is called a polycation. So there is also a case called a monocation. What is by monocation? See this diagram. See the diagram of the first. See the diagram of dicational cyme. Think about this inflorescence. This left side branch is not developing. This left side branch is not developing. So it grows right side. On this branchlet also, left side flower is not developing. Left side flower is not developing. See the diagram here. See this diagram. This is the terminal flower ended in a terminal, or the inflorescence tip ended in a flower. From the bract, from the lateral bud, a pedangle develop, a small pedicel develop. There comes a flower. From the lateral bud, again a branch comes, or flower one. What does it mean? Helicoid. This is called a monocational cyme because the inflorescence or the lateral buds are produced to only one side. One side lot matram flower undai povadathu kondu it tends to curve. One side lot matram ina curve edhi. This is called a helicoid cyme. So monocational cyme is the cymose inflorescence where one of the lateral spikelet, branchlet, fails to develop. So the growth is towards one side. This is called a monocational cyme. And if always the bud develops towards one side, that is called a helicoid, because it form a helical structure. But at the same time, alternatively, if flowers are developed on the right and left side, see this diagram. Here the flower in this branch, left side bud develop. But here, right side bud develop. Then left side bud develop. So when the inflorescence or when the flowers are produced in a right and left pattern, and all are pedicellate flowers, they are having bracts. This is called scorpioid. Okay. So in helicoid sense, so cymose inflorescence are of different types. One is solitary or simple sign. Then there is dicotyl sign. Then there is monocotyl signs, scorpioid and helicoid, and polycotyl sign. Now, there are also some special type of inflorescence called the cyathium, verticillastra, and hypanthodium. That we will discuss later. Now, see the diagram. We learned about racemose and cymose inflorescence. See this diagram. You know this cleomyscosa, kattu kadugu, allengil kadugu chedi nokki ennu nokkiyaa. The flower is like this. Top the flowers, thaazhe fruits undu. Ee inflorescence tippile buds aanu, developing buds aanu. Thaazhe fruits aanu. Open the flowers moonlotte ingane varunu. And here what happens is, ore flowers nu endundu pedicel undu. And this kind of inflorescence called the racemose or racemose inflorescence. Simple receive another. Now, then we discussed about panicle. See, the tip is growing. The tip is growing. Lateral buds are lateral. Side load simple receives the wind one down. Then we need the plants in the veranda. Panicle. An example is alpha alpha. Now see. This is called a spike. I told you about sessile flowers. Flowers are developed in an acropetal succession. Older flowers are seen towards base, younger flowers towards tip. The tip is growing, and these are called, this is a compound spike. Multiple spike on the chair and a compound spike. This is a single spike. And plant we can see, number naughty kind of the plant, Acaranthus aspera. This is called a spadix. I told you, branches is fleshy and thick, and flowers are covered by one or more spathy bract. Example banana, andorium, idella endana spadix aanu, spadix. Okay, now this is called a catkin. You know the mulberry, mulberry plant arillo, mulberry. So mulberry is also an example of catkin. Here sessile flowers are arranged, and this is pendently arranging. Smaller flowers are on the tip and older flowers are towards the base. And this is called a spikelet. As I told you, this we see in the case of paddy. There are large bracts are called glumes. Large bracts are called glumes. Then there is another one bract called a lemma. There is another one bract called the palia. Then anther. And this is the ovary. Like this, flowers are present in a spikelet. In other words, one spike in the various flowers are going to come out. Okay. And here, each flowers are subtended by lemma, palia, and glumes. Lemma, palia, and glumes, where lemma is bract, lemma is bract, palia is bracteole, and these glumes are leaf like structures below the bract. Bract in the thara kanadana is structures. And this is the corypous inflorescence. I told you in the case of Rajamalli, here terminal bud is smaller, older flowers are seen towards the periphery. See this diagram. The terminal flower is smaller, older flowers are seen towards the periphery. This is smaller flowers and these are the larger flowers. And you can take the example Rajamalli, Sessalpinia indica, and this is Sessalpinia pulcherrima. And this is called umbel inflorescence. നമ്മുടെ നാട്ടിലും ഉണ്ട് ബയോഫൈറ്റം, മുക്കുറ്റി എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ പ്ലാന്റ് ഉണ്ട് നമ്മുടെ നാട്ടിൽ, ബയോഫൈറ്റം അല്ലെങ്കിൽ മുക്കുറ്റി. ദാറ്റ്സ് എ ടിപ്പിക്കൽ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ഫോർ അമ്പൽ ഇൻഫ്ലോറസൻസ്. സീ ദ ഡയഗ്രാം, സീ ഈച്ച്, ദിസ് ഈസ് ദ പോയിന്റ്, ദിസ് ഈസ് ഡയഗ്രാം, ദിസ് പോയിന്റ് ഈസ് കോൾഡ് ഷോർട്ട് എൻഡ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ കംപ്രസ്ഡ് ബ്രാഞ്ചസ്. ഫ്രം ദിസ് പോയിന്റ് ദി ഫ്ലവേഴ്സ് ആർ ഡെവലപ്പിംഗ്, കംപ്രസ്ഡ് ആണ്. ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ ദ ടിപ്പ് വിൽ കണ്ടെയ്ൻ സ്മോളർ ഫ്ലവേഴ്സ്. അങ്ങനെയുള്ള മൾട്ടിപ്പിൾ ഗ്രൂപ്പ്സും ഒരു ഒരു പോയിന്റിൽ നിന്ന് മൾട്ടിപ്പിൾ ബഞ്ച് ഓഫ് ഫ്ലവേഴ്സ് ഇതിനകത്ത് വരാറുണ്ട്.